Well, the Florida Keys are bracing for Hurricane Irma. Forecasters are expecting the storm to hit the islands by daybreak tomorrow morning with winds of over 110 miles per hour. David Ovalle, a reporter from the Miami Herald, is covering the storm from Key West, Florida. David, can you tell us what the conditions are right now? What are you seeing?
Well, the conditions are starting to deteriorate. It was actually pretty decent up until maybe about 40 minutes ago. Starting to get little rain bands, and the water levels are really starting to rise, and the waves are really starting to come in. So it's starting to get really ugly. Of course, it's just very beginning stages of the storm. We haven't seen anything yet. So it's just sort of a little bit of a calm before the real storm.
You mentioned the calm. We're looking at some of the video you shot. You can see the waves crashing up against the shore here, right up against this gate. Do you get the sense that people have evacuated and have left the area? Because the governor of Florida has said this is not safe, this area at all. No place in the Keys is safe.
I would probably say most people in Key West have, but there's still a significant amount of people who have decided to stick it out. So just this morning, we were down in the shelter of last resort at Key West High School, and there was hundreds of people who were there. And I talked to some of them, and they told me, you know, we thought we could ride it out, but then once we started seeing the forecast and all the dire predictions, we just said, you know what, let's not risk it. So, you know, there's no beds, there's no real provisions, but people are just bringing all their stuff and their dogs. But there's still a lot of people out there. There's just a bunch of guys, homeless guys out in Duval Street, and they were saying they're going to ride it out in the stormfront where they always hang out. I hope they don't mean that, but, you know, there's definitely some people out there. And as you saw, there's people sort of taking pictures and going to where all the seas are rising over the iconic southernmost point marker here in Key West.
You mentioned the high school there. I know throughout the state of Florida, they're using junior high schools and high schools as shelters for folks. Can the shelter there, the high school there in Key West, withstand a Category 4 potentially?
Absolutely. It's built like a fortress, and it's, you know, they say it's hurricane Category 5 resistant. So, and it's on a little bit higher ground, so it should be safe. Now, it doesn't mean it's not going to be terrifying for the people inside. A lot of dogs, a lot of kids, a lot of elderly people who weren't able to evacuate. So, yes, it's definitely going to withstand it, but it's not going to be an easy experience.
And David, what's your plan for the next 24 to 48 hours?
Well, we're hunkered down in an old Masonic lodge that's, you know, concrete and, you know, really thick concrete built a long time ago. We're up on the third story because the storm surge really is what you have to worry about in addition to the winds. So, you know, Key West is so flat and the waters are really going to rise fast. So it's good we're on the third floor and, you know, just this will be my 16th named storm that I cover. So, you know, I think hopefully this one will end successfully for us being safe. And then comes the real work in covering the aftermath.
David Ovalle with the Miami Herald. I want to thank you, David. Please take care of yourself.
Thank you. Appreciate it.